Breaking news update. We just learned that actually 11 people are now reported shot on Canal Street in New Orleans overnight. Now police are searching for a woman wanted for information about a deadly fire in Phoenix City. And right now authorities are looking for suspects that they say killed a woman and kidnapped another. New tonight, we have just learned two Fairfield police officers have been arrested. This morning, 14 people are dead after a deadly shootout in a Mexican town near the border. Right now, several bills refueling the abortion debate. This morning, we're working to learn more information after multiple people were killed at an apartment complex in Centerpoint. At 9:30, the Trump campaign says it will fire several of its pollsters after the leak of a not-so-great. Today is expected to be the busiest travel day ever for U.S. Airlines. The National Weather Service. All new at 9:30, Moulton's Fire Department says it desperately needs a ladder truck after a devastating fire destroyed several buildings in the downtown square back in April. New at 9:30, health officials have investigated over 80 cases of suspected measles in Alabama. Right now, Birmingham police are investigating a deadly triple shooting. During that spree, police say the man hit a newborn baby in the head. Bill got a huge scare after a teenager started firing off shots at a high school football game on Friday.
You know, with that storm system, what it did in other states, we certainly dodged a bullet.
Absolutely. Yeah. Just a lot of downed trees in that area, but they worked pretty quickly to get rid of that. But let's check in and see what the newest information is right now with meteorologist Matt Daniel. What's going on? We are learning new details about that deadly shooting this weekend at a graduation party in Atmore. Some high school students in our state are spending part of their summer learning about the dangers of distracted driving.
Oh, that's right.
Now, later this week, one of the three suspects arrested in the disappearance of Anaya Blanchard is scheduled to be in court. Some scary looking clouds here for sure, but the National Weather Service confirms no tornadoes touched down. Have you ever taken a photo of someone without their consent? Governor Kay Ivey just signed a bill. Some of you may be dealing with sickness, and that's because the flu season is making its way through our state. Now, right here in Birmingham, police are investigating a shooting that left one person dead. One little girl in California is being recognized for her kindness. I love this story. She's selling cookies and hot cocoa, all to help pay off negative lunch balances at her school. Hurricane Dorian continues to make its way to the U.S. mainland. Florida residents have been preparing all week. New at 9:30, friends and family say goodbye to a man being called a hero following the deadly shooting at UNC Charlotte. We continue our team coverage. Mickey Ferguson, you've really been all over the place today. You were in the Fox 6 Storm Tracker. Where are you right now? I hear you're checking out those road conditions. This is a live picture you're taking a look at right now as investigators continue to look into the scene right now. We're going to keep you guys updated throughout the newscast as this developing story continues to unfold in New Orleans. Again, 10 people shot, 2 in critical condition, 1 person detained, but unclear how they are connected. We're going to continue to follow this. They may look like junk mail, but the recall notices you're getting may include important items on your vehicle that need to be fixed. But as protesters are taking to the state capitol steps to rally against Alabama's new abortion law. Happening this weekend, the Rocket City Trash Pandas. Yeah, you heard me correctly. That's Huntsville's new minor league baseball team, and they will be revealing all 5 of their official team uniforms. Now check this out. If you get pulled over by police in Rochester, Minnesota, for having a light out instead of getting a ticket by police, they're going to give you a voucher for a free replacement light bulb.
We need that here.
19-year-old was killed along with Howell in that shooting. According to a Democratic House Judiciary member, the committee has reached a tentative date for special counsel Robert Mueller's to testify. New video shows a violent and terrifying robbery at a Verizon wireless store in Houston. You can see one robber even manages to disarm a police officer, then forces her to the ground. Well, are you planning to serve spaghetti for dinner this week? You might want to check the pasta sauce first. On your side tonight with alarming numbers on suicide rates, according to a new study.
This one is a little bit different.
Yeah, it's actually a place called the Rattlesnake Saloon, and it's built underneath a rock, but this is no common reptile. It's a restaurant where strangers become friends, and it's absolutely Alabama. investigating. They are two people that are actually in critical condition. One person was detained, but it's unclear how they are connected to this. Right now, thousands of people are actually in town in New Orleans for the Bayou Classic. We'll have more updates coming from this shortly. New at 9, four family members were found dead inside a home in Iowa. Officers say. New tonight, a YouTube star sentenced to 10 years behind bars after asking underage fans to send videos of themselves twerking. Two teen girls just this was all caught on camera. Wow, look at that. Arizona after being swept away by flooding. Authorities have confirmed that two of those children have been found dead after floodwaters swept up their vehicle. Authorities looking for suspects after a woman was held against her will. We are learning more about how this could also be tied to a homicide in Jefferson County. Yeah, the biggest storylines for both teams revolving around quarterbacks. And listen to this. For Alabama, the winners of their game got to eat a steak dinner while the losers were eating beans. We have new video this morning of that flooding you were talking about in North Alabama. Some areas in Florence actually saw up to 4 inches of rain on Saturday.
Of his grandson.
Gray Network's Katie Kamen shows us how this gift brings a little more color into the granddad's world. Business Saturday is over, but that doesn't mean that you cannot still support our local stores, many of which will still have discounts throughout the entire holiday season. Played in the World Series. The score right now 3-1 for the Tigers, and no Auburn game would be complete without fans cheering them on. More information this morning on the tragedy out of West Texas. At least 5 people are dead and even more are injured after a mass shooting in Odessa and Midland. Melissa Rainey shows us new video of those terrifying moments after shots were fired. According to the CDC, there are over 700 confirmed cases of measles in the United States. Abusive parents are hopping state to state, escaping the attention of authorities who may have no idea these parents have past issues. This is a secondary violation, which means you can't be pulled over for the backseat passenger not wearing a seatbelt. If you happen to be watching the game in Auburn, here's a heads up for you. No matter who wins tonight, university officials are out. Storm damage this morning from Mississippi. This is from Flora, located north of Jackson. You can see damage to this gas station. It looks like the storm literally ripped off the roof from the awning. Also, we're still waiting to hear more about a really sad incident in Vestavia Hills. Police tell us what they believe to be an accidental shooting in the parking lot outside of Chuck E. Cheese.
Been several reports of gators in North Alabama in recent weeks.
Yikes. Obviously, there was this one in Decatur near the walking trails at Point Mallard, but the Lauderdale County Sheriff's Office also reported a man. Have you ever taken a photo of someone without their consent? Well, Governor Kay Ivey, the Brass family says that they'll always remember the act of kindness as an extra reason to be grateful on Thanksgiving. Now, a lot of us are going to be shopping for Cyber Monday, so a lot of packages are going to be coming to our front door. California actually has the biggest porch pirate problem, accounting for 30% of these crimes nationwide. Tonight, the community coming together to fight crime with water.
Right, this event, gun
work to revitalize downtown Montevallo will continue. Montevallo Main Street once again has met the rigorous performance standards set by National Main Street Center. Health officials say the best way to protect yourself against the measles virus is to get vaccinated. On camera, a police chase in New Jersey, but it's not what you think. Dash cam video recently released shows a car speeding down a highway with its hazard lights on. Now, this was the back in September. New Jersey State Troopers signaled for the car to pull over. One officer, as you saw there, approached with his gun drawn, not knowing what to expect. Now, that's when he realized that there was actually a woman in the passenger seat in labor. Troopers escorted the couple to a local hospital. WBRC Fox 6 meteorologist Wes Wyatt joining us now. And Wes, I know it's not officially summer, but it sure does feel like it outside.
Let me tell you what.
Auburn and Alabama recording the second highest scoring Iron Bowl in history.
Any idea?
Yes, we will be joining our sister gray stations across the nation by playing the national anthem. This is what you can expect to hear every day just before Good Day Alabama. Overindulge on some of our favorites. but unfortunately most of them are unhealthy foods. We're getting new video of that flooding that Fred was just talking about in North Alabama. First responders were called to a vehicle that was swept off in floodwaters in Madison County. It's unclear if anyone was inside the vehicle, but take a look at this flooded street. It rained so much, turning the streets really into rivers in some areas. Responding to a family's home, not once, but twice on Thanksgiving Day. For those of you going home for the holidays, be prepared for the trip to take a while. AAA says this holiday season will probably break records. The Iron Bowl had fans on both sides on the edge of their seats. I know I was, whether they were at the game in the plains or watching from their homes or at parties around the state. We checked in with fans at Char Bar, and one of them that we found is actually pretty unique. Ron Davidson says he is a dual fan. He began his college career at Auburn, but graduated from Bama. Not only saving lives, but saving the holidays. The Brass family says that they'll remember the act of kindness as an extra reason to be grateful on Thanksgiving. All right, coming up, Cyber Monday is tomorrow, but be aware. Coming up a little later, we're on your side with a warning about possible scams. You're watching WBRC Fox 6 News on your side.